I would appreciate, just again for the same purpose, that everybody should introduce themselves, starting with Fred.
Fred Price, my assistant commissioner of the mayor's community affairs office.
Definitely, I'm assistant chief Carol Nelson, commanding officer of Brooklyn North.
County chief Terry Cashin, fire department, Brooklyn Borough.
Dave Colon, executive officer of the community affairs bureau.
Inspector Gerald Dyke, commanding officer, Housing Borough, Brooklyn.
Brian McGinn, commanding officer, PSA 3.
Mike Kemper, commanding officer, 98th Precinct.
Captain Holmes, Stefan Kovar, executive officer of the 94th Precinct.
Ron Vanessa, director of community affairs for Department of Transportation.
I'm Schneiman, after the DOT is putting it on an ongoing basis, and she didn't make the promise. I just dragged out that promise. It's not official. And I just want to say, and she and her boss are constantly here and making life easier. Sometimes, you know, things happen when they're here on an ongoing basis. If it is issues of a light, trying to ease traffic and whatever issues, they're always available, and we thank you. And of course, the fire department, in addition to the police department, the fire department is an integral part, a vital part of the social, serving our community, and one of the most vital services. Of course, we're just joined by Rabbi Abramowitz, who is the head of the Kesser Nursing Home, in addition to being the head of the Vina Moises. Let me start and do it quickly, because you all know the drill, but again, it's good that we go it over, and we have a calendar here in front of you, which starts, of course, with Rosh Hashanah, and you have the exact time when it starts, and you have the days when it ends, and just to say that you know that, and I'm sure you'll talk about it, how you will have officers dispatched throughout Rosh Hashanah when you don't have the ability, people don't have the ability to contact you by phone, so you'll be out there. Of course, you know, Rosh Hashanah here, the services go, it's a little bit different than other communities who might use the services on a daily basis. The both days of Rosh Hashanah actually starts from, I think, 7 o'clock in Veen, am I right? going till 6 o'clock in the different synagogues, depends where, but then immediately you have Kashrut. When you have thousands of people going to the water, which you know with Tashem Chiz, which is on Kent Avenue, and the importance of making sure that traffic, how traffic moves, and where they should be or should not be, where people should be, and should not be, making sure that there's no injury. So you have Tashlich. And then comes the rest of the week, starting on the Sunday the 12th. So Sunday the 12th, you will have activities, people going for Tashlich. The whole week in the afternoons, you might have people going to Tashlich. Of course, the big one is on the 16th in the afternoon. Thousands of people will go on the 16th, but you will have also people going for Tashlich at the rest of the 12th, 13th, 14th, and 15th. Another activity, those who are here and those who are new over here should know that there is this ritual of Kapurus, which is you have people, a religious ritual with the chickens that are being performed, and it goes on the whole week of the 12th till the morning of Yom Kippur Eve, and that is in the morning of 4 o'clock, you will see masses and larger congregations doing this type of service till about 7 or 8 o'clock.
North, Chief Nelson, Deputy Inspector Michael Kemper, and everybody at the NYPD. And so I have prepared some citations from the New York City Council that I would like to present just to show our appreciation from the Council, show our recognition of the wonderful work that the 90th Precinct has done. And this is just another example of a job well done. So if I may, I would like to present several citations. First, to Deputy Inspector
White. Your own family events or shops, and they're called and they're doing foot patrol. They basically walk away, give up their, not only their personal, but their family comfort for the community. Thank you very much. And we thank the elected officials who are helping, and we'll do whatever we can to make sure that they can continue to work. I would like now to call, as I say, our senior statesman, Assemblyman Joseph Lentor.